Trump's first State of the Union message was a very powerful speech, and characteristically for the president, a lot of very straight talk to Americans. But at the same time, a very sincere and I think helpful call for unity. Unity among Americans and unity between Republicans and Democrats. The president started his speech by going over some of the successes over the past year, obviously focusing first on tax reform, noting that every single income category in America got a tax cut, not a tax increase like often has been reported, and that we have finally been able to reduce our corporate tax rates in a way that makes America competitive across the globe again, instead of having the highest corporate tax rate in the world. He talked about how this means to an average family of $75,000 in this country about a $4,000 increase in their wages and about a $2,000 cut in their taxes. This kind of growth is the kind of thing that is giving Americans and companies across this country confidence in our economy. He talked about the fact that we are also reducing the explosive growth of government that we have seen for so many years now, and that the regulatory world in America is shrinking and shrinking rapidly. Some estimates have said that we now have a Federal Register that's only two-thirds the size it was just a year ago. And of course, the president pointed out that we have eliminated the individual mandate of Obamacare, one of the core parts of Obamacare that we are now continuing to work on eliminating and reforming. And the president then moved on to one of the most important topics to me, and I think most Idahoans, and that is the fact that we have made significant progress in restructuring and reforming our judiciary, getting a strong focus among judges across this country on following our Constitution and interpreting our laws as they were written, not as the judges wanted them to be written. And obviously, that we have now a very powerful new Supreme Court justice in Neil Gorsuch, which keeps that balance strong in favor of a constitutionally oriented Supreme Court. We should also point out, though the president didn't tonight in his speech, that one of those judges is a new district judge for Idaho, Judge Nye, who we are all really proud to see assume the bench. The president then went on to call for Congress to come together and build bipartisan solutions in a number of very critical areas. Things like infrastructure, where America needs to make the continued investments that will help our economy get even stronger. And immigration, where we have some significant conflicts in the United States, but where we so badly need to find a bipartisan solution to move forward. And the president also called for Congress to come together, quit fighting, and join in unified support of a strong military. He talked about the fact that he has recently changed the rules of engagement to allow the men and women of our fighting forces to fight without the restrictions of such restraints that have been imposed on them in the past. When I think of the men and women at Mountain Home Air Force Base and at Gowan Field and other heroic Americans who are fighting across this globe, and Idahoans who are fighting across this globe to defend our freedoms, I'm glad that we have a president who's calling for a strong and renewed commitment to strengthen our military and to let the men and women who are called on to put themselves on the line for our freedoms to have the rules of engagement to do so. He also concluded his speech in a way that I thought was incredibly powerful. He talked about the Statue of Freedom that is on top of the Capitol Dome in Washington, D.C. Talked about the fact that there were so many other monuments to our freedom throughout this city, Washington, D.C., and concluded with the fact that the statue, whose name is Freedom, represents what this is all about, and that the very Capitol itself, where we are now doing business, where the Congress is now being asked by the President to work on these critical issues, is itself one of the most important monuments among all those in Washington, D.C. I don't know how any American watching could not have been touched by these concluding remarks of the president as he asked us to come together, to unify, and to work to find solutions to these important issues for the objective of freedom in this great nation.